What's up guys, my name is Mario, and on this video I'm going to show you how to install the Google Pixel 2 launcher on your Samsung Galaxy S8 phone. Make sure you watch the entire video because I'm going to show you how to fix some of the errors that you're going to get during the installation. So the first thing we want to do is, down in the description below, I have a link that is going to take you to the actual APK Mirror website where you're going to be able to download the Pixel Launcher APK. Just go ahead and click on that. And now this is going to apply for any APK that you download online, so just keep that in mind. Once you open the site, you're actually going to scroll down to the bottom of the page until you see Download APK. Now, if there's a new version available, you're going to get a message right here. So you can actually scroll to the bottom of the page and you can see the different versions. Since I've been working with this particular version, and that's the one that I installed a couple of weeks ago and I know it's working well, this is what we're going to use for this video. So you're going to go ahead and click on Download APK. Give it a few seconds. You're going to have another page that is going to download, and you should get a notification down here asking if you want to download it. Go ahead and click on Download and confirm. Once the download is completed, you can click Open. Or if you missed that, on the top, you just bring your notification bar down and click under Download Manager. You're going to see the download is completed for the google.android.apps Nexus launcher. Go ahead and open that up, and here, just give it a few seconds. Then you're gonna have your first issue here. So it's going to tell you that in order to install a custom APK, you're going to have to actually go and enable it. We're not downloading this from the Samsung App Store or the Google Play Store. We have to actually click on Enable the Unknown Sources. Once you click OK, we have enabled it, and it's going to take us back to the installation. So from here, you just make sure you have the Pixel Launcher, and on the bottom right hand side, just click on Install. If everything goes as expected, it will install, but you're going to have an error because you probably have the secure folder on, and we're going to cover that in a second. So if everything goes as expected, just click Done, and we go back to the main page, main launcher. So the next thing we want to do is, before we actually open the launcher, we go up here to Settings and then click on Apps. We're going to go to top right hand side again and click on Default Apps. You're going to have, one more time, you're going to have your default app selection. Let's click on the home screen. You will have TouchWiz home by default. So if we click on Pixel Launcher, we're going to set that by default. We go back to the home screen and it's going to crash, right? You're going to get this Pixel Launcher has stopped. And the reason is because you have to uninstall or disable your secure folder. If you don't know what that is, then you probably don't use it. So you can go ahead and uninstall it. And anytime you want it, you can enable it again. Let's go back to top right hand side. We click on the settings, scroll down to the actual lock screen and security settings, scroll down a little bit more. Right under unknown sources, you're going to have the secure folder. We click on that. Just going to put the pattern. And what we want to do here is just, we want to uninstall it. So here you're going to click on more settings. And on the bottom right hand, on the bottom, you click on uninstall. Just confirm the uninstall and let it go through the installation. Once it's complete, you're probably going to get this option down here where it's going to ask you if you want to select the launcher. You can just click on Pixel Launcher and it should work after this if everything went as expected. And there you have it. So the first thing you're going to notice is top right hand side, you're going to actually have your little calendar, and then you're also going to have a small notification for the weather. If you actually press on it once, it will open the app itself. Same goes for the calendar. If you want to change the settings, you just hold press on it and you're going to have the preference. You can enable the calendar events, the upcoming flight information, and all the traffic information. If you want to get notifications, since I don't really use this, I usually just turn this off. You're going to notice that all my icons are actually gone, so I'm going to have to come back and reconfigure this. Just bring all the icons that I usually use. I can just bring them back to the home screen. Pretty easy to do. Towards the bottom, you're going to have your quick launch icons. You can actually just, the apps, you just customize it, put them in there, or just move them around as you desire. And towards the bottom, you have the quick search bar from Google Search. Now going into your app drawer, it is pretty similar. It's just the icons are going to be smaller. If you want to change the wallpaper, this is something else you have to keep in mind. Originally, it's going to try to find the wallpapers from actually the Google app, and it's not going to be there. So you have to actually go in and install the app. And what you do here is you basically go back to your Google Play Store, search for wallpapers, and the wallpapers app is going to be right here. This is made by Google. You just install it. Once installation is complete, you open it and you should see different wallpapers. Now we go back to the main page. Let's go to the wallpapers, bottom right hand side. As you can see, this time we don't get the error. We get multiple wallpapers to select. The only thing you have to keep in mind is that most of these wallpapers are not compatible, or at least they don't work for this phone. If I try to select them, I'm gonna get an error saying that it was not able to install it. Some of them, it will install with no issues, so you just have to play with it. This one, just as you notice, it just gave me the error. If I go back down to the wallpapers, going back to the Nova wallpapers that I had originally from the previous launcher, this one I can install with no issues. So overall, I have been using this launcher for about 3 to 4 weeks now, and I haven't found any issues but one. Well, I guess I have found one issue. The only niche issue that I found is that if I actually hide the notification bar down here, sometimes it's hard to bring it back up. So if I open one of the apps, for example, and I just scroll up a few times, it will not come up. So I will have to basically either turn off the phone, not turn off, but just make it go to sleep, or just wait a few seconds until it actually shows. Other than that, the launcher works great. I don't have any issues with the lagging. In fact, I think it actually works a little bit smoother compared to the original stock launcher that it comes with the Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus. So definitely this is something you can do. There's no root required on the phone, something you can install easily. And if you don't like, you can always just remove it. Hope you guys like it. Make sure you hit the like button if you enjoyed this content. And if you enjoy tech reviews, make sure you subscribe to this channel. I do tech reviews every week. All right, guys, I'll see you on the next one.